weekend. And did you take your bike all the way there?
Yes, my bike is here along with our command center and our voter registration team. With your intro there, you know, there are a lot of predictions that have been made. There were predictions that over 5% of the people that caught this would actually die, when actually it's less than 1%. So we have to mitigate these predictions and put them in perspective. And a lot of us believe this might be a plandemic as opposed to a pandemic. And I, for one, am one of them. But that being said, we do have several hundred masks outside my command center where we're doing voter registration. The restaurant I was just at had a Biker for Trump rally, has over 10 gallons of hand sanitizer and 5,000 masks. So we're taking the precautions that we need to take, but quite frankly, I think it's being blown out of proportion. I think this is being polarized by the left because of the simple fact that they would like mail-in ballots, and that might be the only chance they have of beating our president if they have an opportunity to maybe cheat a little bit.
Chris, let me ask you something. I appreciate the fact that you're holding voter registration events. It's important to have people have access to the ability to voice their thoughts in that way. But I want to clarify here. Did you say that you subscribe to the idea that this was a planned pandemic?
Well, it would seem so. The fact that they predicted over 5% of the population that got the virus would die, when in fact it's less than 1%.
But hold on, wait. I'm not talking about the projections. I'm asking you if you believe that this pandemic, coronavirus, COVID-19, was planned.
I believe that it's being polarized by the left for the simple fact that they want to.
I'm not asking you about the political reaction. Do you think that this is a plan by some nefarious organization to hurt Americans?
I think this is a plan by the left to sink this amazing economy that our president has built greater than anyone else, and that these numbers are being just exaggerated across the board. When we look at, I have a friend that's a doctor in South Carolina that took one of the swabs, put it in an envelope and sent it in. It came back that he was positive. I think that people are dying from heart attacks and strokes, and on their death certificates it's saying that they died of COVID. I think that the COVID is being, if you have a cough or you sneezing or a runny nose, they're saying that you had COVID. But do they really have it? You know, this is, isn't it convenient that this is happening during, on the eve of an election, and that all of these protests are around? And so where you guys aren't happy with the bikers that are coming together, this working collar, the blue collar, and this working class community, the veterans and the rest of them are coming here, but yet we don't hear any pushback when these big demonstrations from Black Lives Matters and other organizations like Antifa are marching through the streets. If we look in Portland, was there any concern, or was your network voicing their concerns about the pandemic spreading in Portland?
Actually, there absolutely, no, there absolutely was, Chris, because I was in the streets with protesters, and the first question that I asked them was, why are you here knowing that there's a pandemic happening right now? It's something that CNN has covered. I'm curious, though, because I have friends who have died from COVID-19. I'm curious, do you think that they died because of the virus, or someone, you know, faked their death or made it up? Because that is extremely offensive.
Well, and it certainly is. And I definitely think this to be taken seriously, but I think it's being blown out of proportion. I think that right now the left sees an opportunity to polarize this situation, to try to get the American where they can mail in their ballots instead of exercising their right to vote at the precinct. And that's what we would like to see. The way that we've done it. Go ahead.
I want to understand your perspective, Chris. I do. And I'm really curious. So you're saying that Democrats planned to release this virus into the United States to beat President Trump in November?
No, I'm not saying that. What I'm saying is that they see this as an opportunity.
Okay. So what I asked you before,
they're trying to see this opportunity to polarize the nation, to exaggerate what's happening right now, to take some of these cases of people that have died from different ailments that their death certificates are saying that they died of COVID, when
so
in fact
somehow,
they died of a heart attack, or
somehow,
they died of diabetes.
Somehow every coroner in every county in the United States is conspiring together to fill out death certificates falsely. Is that what you're suggesting?
I think that we've got to do some political math here. Isn't it?
Do you understand how a death certificate process works, Chris?
Of a president has had an assault against them on every turn that he's made. I mean,
Chris, do you understand the process that doctors and coroners go through when someone dies to fill out a death certificate? It's a legal process, and it has to be verified by a coroner. There are coroners in every county in the United States. For what you're saying to be true, all of these coroners from across the country have to be sitting in a room conspiring to falsify death certificates. Is that really what you're saying?
I'm saying that it's being reported by doctors on both sides that this is not as bad as it's being reported to be. I'm suggesting that a lot of people are dying from different things, and their death certificates are coming out to say they died of COVID. I told you I have firsthand experience of someone sending in a test swab without even touching it with the rubber glove, and it coming back that they were tested positive.
Chris, when,
I have
when
friends
we...
that have been in line to get the COVID test because it took so long they left, and then because they left, it was reported that they were told they had COVID when in fact they didn't.
That's fascinating, and I wish that you would stay on the line with us after this interview to give us their contact information so that we can have them on CNN. And if not CNN, Fox News or Reuters or any other news organization, because that deserves to be exposed. I have another question for you. If all these coroners are conspiring to falsify the numbers, as you've suggested, then what about other countries? Why have almost 20 million people around the world been reported to have died from coronavirus? Are there coroners in all these other countries? Rather, forgive me, 20 million cases, some nearly 725,000 deaths. Are coroners in other countries also falsifying death certificates?
Well, let me ask you this. Are more people dying from the common flu? Are more people dying from car accidents? Are more people dying from AIDS? Are more people dying, just from...
I appreciate the attempt to deflect. I appreciate the attempt to deflect from the question, but I'm asking you if you think that people in other countries are also faking their numbers and if Democrats are somehow controlling them too, Chris.
No, I don't think that the Democrats are behind it, but I think that they are trying to polarize this nation.
Okay,
I think
fair.
They're trying to use this as a stepping stone to try to get mail-in ballots, which is just absurd. We need to go to the polls and exercise our right to vote. There's too much wiggle room for cheating if we mail in our ballots.
If you believe that Democrats are playing politics with this, that's one thing. But if you believe that there's actually a conspiracy to fake deaths, that's an entire, or to fake the cause of death, that's an entire other subject. But I want to go back to the question I asked you, because you mentioned that a lot of your organization believes that this is a planned pandemic. And I want to ask you again, just to clarify the point. Do you believe that some nefarious organization actually planned to put this in the United States to affect the outcome of the election? Was this by design, Chris?
Well, that remains to be seen. I'm not a conspiracy theorist. I need to see hard evidence before I am able to ascertain an answer for that. But I do believe this is being polarized by the left, and it's going to be blown out of proportion. And I think that the time will show that it's not as bad as they're saying it is. After November 3rd, I have a feeling this is going to disappear. To